السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأصلي وأسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. ما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. جزاكم الله خير for attending. May Allah سبحانه وتعالى accept our deeds, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all of us. I like to remind that alhamdulillah we have Quran class for our sons and also for you, for the adults. Okay, every Sunday, Tuesday and Thursday. It starts يعني the Sheikh is available here, jazakallah khair, يعني from Isha or from 6 until 9 p.m. Okay, so maybe for today you can bring your son, not necessarily every day. Okay, if you cannot, at least bring Tuesday so you can send your son upstairs in the second floor and you attend the halqa. Or both of you can come before the halqa. Alhamdulillah, now Isha is early. So from, for example, from 7 to 8, you stay with the Shaykh to learn. Take يعني, this opportunity. Alhamdulillah, this is free. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all of us. And also the other thing I remind that, please, as they put, share, okay, like, subscribe, do everything, okay, put comments. طيب. And يعني جزاهم الله خير, the brothers are doing good effort. Brother Azhar, Brother Umar George, طيب. They are uploading, filming the lectures, uploading the lectures. So try to support them. Okay, like, subscribe, share. Okay, also my channel. And also the channel of the Lajna. There is an Instagram, Hidayah Kuwait, Instagram. Okay, you can find, inshallah, some lectures. Inshallah, in the future, we'll try to post something more. And we try to remove what is not needed and we add what is good and beneficial, inshallah. Try to be positive. Try to be active for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not necessarily يعني, here in the Lajna, in any place. The Muslim should be active any place. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, رُبَّا شَعَثْ أَغْبَرْ دُوْتِمْ رَيْنْ لَوْ أَقْسَمْ عَلَى اللَّهِ لَأَبَرَّهِ. Okay, the narration in كان في الساقة في الساقة كان في الحراسة في الحراسة. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم mentioned one the example of the Muslim. If he asks Allah سبحانه وتعالى, Allah will answer him. But سبحانه, when you see him, you think he is nothing. Okay, people will push him, people will not listen to him, people will not marry him, their daughters. But so, and also he is very simple. This is very important. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "This kind of Muslim, in kana fil hirasa fil hirasa, in kana fil saqa fil saqa." Okay, يعني in the army, you know different names in the army. The Muslim army or any army. Okay, all the army the same. All of them attack. All of them defend. Different. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned, "Subhanallah, this kind of Muslim, if you tell him to stay here, he will stay. He will do his job. Stay in the back, he will do his job." Maybe you need him to cook. He will do his job. This is the point, brothers. This is the point. That do your job. Do your job. Wallahi, inshallah, يعني, if every one of us does his job, okay, for example, for me, I give the lecture. For you, you attend the lecture. For the third, to share the lecture. For the fourth, he will translate the lecture. He will give da'wah outside. This person will do street da'wah. The other one will travel. Imagine if everyone does. Don't say I cannot. Don't say I don't know what to do. You can do a lot, inshallah. By the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب. The last thing. We're talking about the new Muslims. طيب, and we reached to a hadith ثمامة ابن أثال, long hadith. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم mentioned, sorry, ثمامة رضي الله تعالى عنه said to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, "You captured me on my way to perform Umrah." He was not Muslim. He was going to perform Umrah. How? He was not Muslim, going to perform Umrah. Yes, the mushriks were doing Umrah Hajj. صح. Yes or no? Yes. But they are doing wrong things. For example, they were, when we go to Hajj or Umrah, what we say? تلبية، لبيك اللهم لبيك، لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك، إن الحمد والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك. دز أور تلبية، أور تلبية توحيد. They do تلبية، they say تلبية، but what is the problem? The big problem, the major problem, they add شرك. They say لبيك اللهم لبيك، good. لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك، good. إن الحمد والنعمة لك والملك، okay. Sorry. They say لبيك اللهم لبيك، لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك، perfect. Then they say إلا شريكا هو لك، except a partner. استغفر الله العظيم. So the last part contradicts the first part. So they do Umrah. So Thumama said, O Rasulullah, I was going to perform Umrah, then your army, your friends captured me. Okay? You captured me on my way to perform Umrah. So what should I do? Now I am Muslim. He went to perform Umrah while he was not Muslim. So they captured him. You know the story. I think we mentioned the story. They fixed him in the Masjid al-Nabawi. And one of the pillars, okay? They fix him maybe 3 days. After 3 days, he accepted Islam, alhamdulillah. طيب. So now he said, O Rasulullah, you captured me while I'm going to perform the Umrah. So, subhanallah, you remember the hadith last week about Umar, radiallahu ta'ala an, what he said? Nadir, yes, nadir about what? Umar radiallahu ta'ala asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, O Rasul, I gave a vow, I vowed to do i'tikaf one night. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, do your vow, fulfill your vow. Okay, so now, before Islam, I was going to perform Umrah. What should I do? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam first gave him glad tidings. أعطاه البشرى يعني like saying مبروك, you are Muslim, you are a new person now, new baby without any sin. طيب, so the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم first thing gave him glad tidings. So the author put this hadith, why? He wants to tell us this is sunnah. You tell the new Muslim like يعني you tell him مبروك, may Allah forgive all your sins. Accepting Islam means Allah forgives all the sins. Like the newborn baby, without any sin. So the author wants to tell us this hadith means that we give the glad tidings for our brothers and sisters who are new Muslims. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam ordered him to perform his Umrah. Here, Allah, go and continue your Umrah. Your intention was before Islam and now you are Muslim, but you were intending to do something good. So continue the good that you are going to do. Like Umar radiallahu ta'ala, to do i'tikaf in Masjid Haram, this is good or bad? This is good. So the Prophet ﷺ told him to fulfill your vow to Umar. And for Thumama, continue your Umrah. Do your Umrah. طيب, then Thumama, so then Thumama radiallahu ta'ala reached Mecca. They asked him, have you become Sabi'? The one who changed his religion, they call him Sabi'. Okay, so you feel that يعني, they insult him by this word. Sabi', he replied, no, but I became Muslim with Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I became Muslim with Muhammad, the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he was not afraid. I am Muslim, I am not Sabi', whatever you call me, but I am Muslim with Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. طيب. Also, one of the ahadith, Abu Rafi' in page 581, Abu Rafi' radiallahu ta'ala narrated, Quraysh sent me as a messenger to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for negotiation, for something. طيب, to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and as soon as I saw him, he did not talk, He did not hear anything from him. He saw the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Allah placed the religion of Islam in my heart. Allahu Akbar. When I saw him, subhanallah, he saw the peace. He saw the happiness. سيماهم في وجوه من أثر السجود ما شاء الله. Some people, ما شاء الله. When you see them, والله you feel the comfort. صح؟ You don't know him. Okay, but when you see him, ما شاء الله. You feel peace, you feel راحة, tranquility. So when he saw the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, Allah placed Islam in my heart. How? What? He doesn't know what is happening. سبحان الله. Allah placed the religion of Islam in my heart. I said, O Rasulullah, I will never go back to them. خلاص, I am Muslim. I will not go back to Mecca. طيب, this was in the period, you know, in the sixth year and the eighth year. In the sixth year and the eighth year. What was this period? Okay, after Sulh Hudaybiyah, there was, you know, they wrote Sulh Hudaybiyah. Okay, one of the points they told Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Okay, if anyone from Mecca comes to you as Muslim, it is our right to take him back. صح? So now the problem, this man Abu Rafi' radiyallahu ta'ala an came from Mecca to Medina, then he accepted Islam. مشكلة. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam should send him back. Okay, well now what to do? Okay, and also this is one point. And also the other point that Abu Rafi' was a messenger. And it is common at that time, and also now, if there is a messenger, you are not allowed to kill him or to stop him or to put him in the jail. Khalas. Even if you are my enemy. Even if it is between Muslim country and non-Muslim country, you have to respect the rules. So what was the rule? You have to respect the messengers. Don't kill them, don't capture them, don't put them in jail, don't torture them. Khalas. The messenger, his job is to convey the message from that leader to this leader. And also the opposite. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, I don't break the agreement, nor do I keep the messengers. The Prophet ﷺ said, no problem, you are welcome in Islam. But for me, I gave them the pledge. Or I did the contract. And I don't break the contract. Because breaking the contract, khiyana. And it's not allowed in Islam. Shlon, how? We are Muslims and they are kuffar. Khiyana is not allowed. If you remember, we mentioned that some points or some attributes, some kinds of behavior, we can use these behaviors by themselves not haram or wrong. For example, al-makr, al-kaid, al-sukhriya. What's mean al-makr? To plan for someone to trap him in a hidden way. Listihza, to ridicule someone. This is haram. But if as a response is allowed, or for the one who deserves that. This is in the Quran. Allah says, وَيَمْكُرُونَ وَيَمْكُرُ اللَّهِ. What is the meaning of makr? Makr is to plan in a hidden way. Okay, and for example, you want to catch someone and you send him invitation, come, we have walima, we have dinner, we have, okay. Then he will sit after eating, then you capture him. And for example, this is makr. Okay, this is haram, but as a response, this is allowed. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَيَمْكُرُونَ وَيَمْكُرُ اللَّهِ. Allah did not say in the Quran, Allahu makr. No, it came as a response. Okay, وَيَمْكُرُونَ وَيَمْكُرُ اللَّهِ. Another one, الكيد. الكيد also almost the same. Allah says, إِنَّهُمْ يَكِيدُونَ كَيْدًا وَأَكِيدُ كَيْدًا. Okay, so you should notice that it came as
response. It was not alone. So the scholars say it is not allowed to say Allah is al-makir, astaghfirullah. No, it is not allowed. It is not a name. Allah is al-ka'id. No. Also sukhriya, to ridicule. سخر الله منهم. Okay, so they make sukhriya, they ridicule. So and also Allah did the same. So as a response, okay. But when it came to the khiyana, what does mean yakhun? To betray someone. Khiyana. You know khiyana? What is in Urdu? Khiyanat. Then betraying. When it came to khiyana, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not respond the same. Allah said in Surah Al-Anfal, فَقَدْ خَانُوا اللَّهَ مِنْ قَبْلِ فَقَدْ خَانُوا اللَّهَ مِنْ قَبْلِ. Okay? They betrayed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before, previously. Okay? So, what is next? فَخَانَهُمُ اللَّهُ? No. Never. Why? Because this is in any way haram. But Allah said, فَأَمْكَنَ مِنْهُمْ. Brothers, this is very important. We need to understand the Quran. We need to understand also this is very important part in Aqeedah. فَخَانُوا اللَّهَ مِنْ قَبْلِ فَأَمْكَنَ مِنْهُمْ. What does it mean? فَأَمْكَ مِنْهُمْ. يعني Allah made it easy for the Muslims to control them. Okay, is it haram? No, not haram. خلاص, Allah gave the chance for the Muslims to control them or to defeat them. Is it haram? Not haram. But what is haram? To betray, to betray them as a response. This is haram. So that's why we should be careful, brothers, that not everything you are allowed to respond. صح, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us the rule. وَجَزَاءُ سَيِّئَةٍ سَيِّئَةٌ مِثْلُهَا. Okay, what is the الجزاء يعني ها شو الجزاء أبو علي؟ الجزاء يعني for example you give an answer and I give you something gift the reward. Okay, but here it is for good or bad. Okay, so what is the وجزاء سيئة سيئة مثلها. The response of a سيئة, a bad action, it is the same action. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said سيئة مثلها. For example, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said المستبان ما قال فعلى البادئ. المستبان, what does it mean مستبان? If there are two people are insulting each other, okay, he's saying bad word. Someone said to me bad word. Okay, then it is my right to respond. But I respond the same word. Someone said, stupid. I tell him, you are stupid. Is it allowed? Yes, it is allowed. Why? Because I am replying the same. And the sin will be on him. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, المستبان ما قال فعلى الباد. المستبان, what means مستبان? The two people, the two persons who are insulting each other, the sin will be only on one side. Which one? The start. The one who started. إلا أن يتجاوز. Except if the second one exaggerate, he went more. Yeah, for example, he said, stupid. I say to him, you are stupid and crazy. Ah, خلاص. I will take the sin. SubhanAllah, this is Islam, brothers. This is Islam, justice. But of course, no doubt, if you forgive, this is higher. Because if he said to me bad word, I reply the bad word, he will take the sin, but I will not take reward. But if he said bad word to me, then I say, please brother, this is haram, we are Muslims. I give him nasiha and I tell him, khalas, I will forgive you, Allah will reward me. Okay? So, back to our point that khiyana is not allowed. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, I don't break the agreement because this is betraying, haram. What is the agreement? the agreement, if anyone from Mecca comes to as a Muslim, I should what? Return him back. And the second part, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, nor do I keep the messengers, and also I cannot put you in the jail. Why? Because the general rule for all the nations, for all the religions, that the messengers should feel safe and secure, because their job is to give the message. I don't break the agreement, nor do I keep the messengers. Rather, go. Then the Prophet said, rather go back, and if you feel the same way that you do now, then come back. You came now as a messenger, so I cannot keep you with me. But please, go back. And if you still have the same feeling, the feeling of Islam, then you come. You come as a Muslim, not as a messenger for the kuffar. So I went back, Abu Rafi said, I went back and then returned to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam and became Muslim. I came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam as a Muslim. Khalas. What is the difference between the first time and second time? The first time, he came as a messenger from the kuffar. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam cannot tell him, stay. But the second time he escaped as Muslim, you are welcome. You are welcome. طيب. Any question about these two hadith? Sorry? Allah alam, it is not clear. Allah alam, it is not clear. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم told him to come. If you feel the same, you can come. يعني the time is not mentioned in the hadith. Is it after Fath Makkah or not? طيب, next chapter, اللي هو the conduct of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم with those asking for fatwa. Okay, and this is a very important chapter for the scholars, for the teachers, also for the doctors, for the fathers, for the mothers. It is very important. You should know how to answer. يعني the point is not only knowledge. Knowledge alone is not enough. What is the point? Okay, I memorize the book. I memorize Quran, Bukhari, Muslim. But you don't have fiqh. You don't have understanding. You don't have fatwa. يعني for example, what you are telling your son, the 5 years old, the same way and the same information like your daughter, 22 years old, different. If you are a teacher, for example, in a school, you are teaching KG1 or KG2, the same like grade 12, different like the college, different like PhD people, different. Okay? So this is very important. And يعني asking is common in the Quran and Sunnah. For example, only you can find in Surah Al-Baqarah, ويسألونك ماذا ينفقون ويسألونك عن الخمر والميسر, يسألونك عن الأهل, يعني they ask you about the wine, they ask you about the moon, they ask you about the woman, the period, they ask many questions. Is it haram? No. Allah said فاسألوا أهل الذكر إن كنتم لا تعلمون. So the other hadith, when the companion said, "Nuhina an al-su'al," it is forbidden to ask. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, "Fas'alu." Allah said in the Quran, ask the people of dhikr, means the scholars. Okay, how can we take these two ayah and hadith? The hadith means asking يعني, the useless questions, the wrong questions. Asking questions only to show that you have knowledge. Or I want to ask the Shaykh to show that he doesn't know. Then this is not allowed. Or we should avoid like these questions. Which questions that we have to ask if you don't have knowledge and I need this knowledge? I'm going to perform Hajj. Then you have to ask. Where should I go? I go to Mecca or I go to Mina, I go to Arafah. Okay, you have to ask, you have to seek knowledge. Someone is going to, for marriage, he should ask, what are the rights of the husband? What are the rights of the wife? What he and she should ask. Okay, the wudu, the ghusl, the zakah. You have money now. Okay, you have to pay zakah. You have to know what are the rules of zakah. You started your business. You should know what are the rules of business. This is very important, subhanAllah. Yeah, and for business transaction, this is very important. Now, yeah, I will not say everyone is doing business, but many Muslims are doing business. Online business or outside, okay? Offline, online, they are doing business. Our wife's doing business, small business, big business. We are doing business. You have to know what are the rules. And Muslims do a lot of mistakes. They do many mistakes. SubhanAllah. Why? Because they don't seek knowledge. They want only to earn money. No problem, earn money, but it should be through halal way. How can you make sure this is halal or not halal? Study, read. It is important. Sometimes you think that your logic is okay. But now our logic is corrupted by the media. And you know, many people say, it's okay, no, there is no riba. It's okay to deal with the riba. And astaghfirullah al-azim. For many Muslims, it's okay, the riba bank. SubhanAllah, they have no problem. Gambling, no problem. There is a mess in the business. Okay. Also, if you are doing your business at home, you know, especially during Corona, online, subhanAllah. You should know the rules. Maybe I mentioned this point, the gold places, shops, how they sell the gold. Okay? Yeah, they are doing tricky thing. Tricky. Okay? They don't care about halal and haram. But sometimes you ask them, is it halal, not halal? Okay? They will do what? Okay. What satisfies you? As you know, the gold, the Prophet ﷺ said, الذهب بالذهب يدا بيد مثلا بمثل. And nowadays, what is like gold? The money. So if you are going to buy gold, you have to give him the money now, not tomorrow, not after 1 hour. Okay? But now it is online. You remember last year? It was online, everything online. And in the Jam'iyya there is no gold. The shops are closed. They want to do their business. So what they do? You pay the money online. Then they come to your house and you choose which color. Okay, if you tell the woman, no, I did not buy. Okay? He will come, then I will choose. Okay, but why did you pay the money? Okay, tell him, ta'al, come to my house with your car and show me what you have. And if I like, I will buy. If I don't like, yalla ma'a salama. But he will not do that. He will not drive his car for nothing. He will not take the risk 50-50. Alaykum salam. Okay? So this is cheating. What? You cheat yourself. Gold should be, you pay the money, you take now. Even with the visa, is not allowed. Can it? Okay. Why? Because can it? It will go to your account directly. Right? Okay? And the check. If it is confirmed, not any check. Certified, yes. Okay, and some scholars say this is okay. They speak about this. So my point is, you should learn what you are practicing. You are a doctor, you have to learn what are the rules of awrah. What are the rules of using this medicine? You know, sometimes the medicine, this has something haram. Is it allowed to use it? Can we use another thing? You have to study your field. You have to study your field. Okay? So in this chapter, the Prophet how what are the techniques of answering the questions from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam?
طيب
there is a point that you'll find sometimes different several answers for the same question. Oh Rasulullah, what is the best deed? He will give one answer here. Tomorrow, another answer for the same question, for this person. So why? They say, the scholars say, because the Prophet ﷺ is giving the answer according to the person. يعني for example, if I notice this person has parents, okay, so I should mention the parents in the answer. For a person who can't do the Hajj, he's not doing Hajj, I will mention the Hajj. All of them good, perfect deeds. But you'll find the Prophet ﷺ giving different answers. Why? According to the person. According to the... Yani for example, if a man or a woman, 15 years old, you tell him about being kind to the parents or being kind to the children? To the parents. He's 15 years old. Okay? A rich person. Okay, you tell him the rules of zakah or the rules of to take money. I tell him the rules of zakah. But if there is a poor guy comes, I tell him the rules of zakah, he's maskeen. He needs the zakah. I tell him you have to pay this if you have farm, you have to pay this if you have camels. You need to be wise. Okay, how to answer? What to answer? This is very important. Yeah, for example, Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu ta'ala reported, I asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what is the best deed? He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied, the prayer at its time. I asked, then what? He said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, being good to one's parents, birrul walidain. I asked, then what? He said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, jihad in the path of Allah. Jihad fi sabilillah. Okay? Another hadith, Abu Huraira said, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked about the best deed. The same question. What was the answer? Belief in Allah and His Messenger. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked then, what was next? So he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, jihad in the path of Allah. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, accepted hajj. Hajj mabrur. Different answer. Okay, so I can give different answer for the same question according to what? According to the person, to the situation, to the environment. Of course, I don't mean that we bring something wrong or haram. You should be within the Quran and Sunnah. And this needs knowledge. So, brothers, the main thing is knowledge. If you have knowledge, then you can use this knowledge. Where to fix this answer and where to fix the other answer. But the problem, if you don't have knowledge, how can you answer? Okay? You'll do mistakes, a lot of mistakes. You misguide people. طيب. يعني he mentioned many hadith, for example, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked, what is the best jihad? What is the best jihad? He said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the one who fights the disbelievers with his wealth and his self. This is the best jihad. Alayhi salatu wa sallam. طيب, hadith عائشة رضي الله تعالى عنها. O Rasulullah, we see that jihad is the best action. We see that jihad is the best action. طيب, if you remember that hadith, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم mentioned the salah. Here, jihad. Should not we women fight? The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, no. But the best jihad is an accepted hajj. ولكن أفضل جهاد حج مبرور. طيب عليه الصلاة والسلام. Also a word, sorry, a hadith of jihad. What is the best jihad? The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, replied, a word of truth in front of an oppressive ruler. كلمة حق عند سلطان جائر. So you find different answer for for asking about the jihad. Okay, يعني the point here, يعني the sheikh here or the author doesn't want to tell us the hadith, what is the meaning of jihad and what is the meaning of hajj. He wants to tell us the technique in answering the questions. And it should be this technique from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And I like to emphasize the point of knowledge. The knowledge from Quran and Sunnah. يعني please, what is the point that I study what are the techniques and I don't have the knowledge? Like the one who studies the techniques of da'wah, he doesn't have knowledge. How can you give da'wah without knowledge? Okay, you need knowledge for the da'wah. You need knowledge for the salah. You need knowledge for the zakah, the hajj. You need knowledge for your Islam. طيب. Also, Abu Ayyub, page 586. Abu Ayyub radiyallahu ta'ala narrated that a man asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, tell me about a deed that enabled me to enter paradise. The people said, what is with him? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, he has a need. Worship Allah and don't associate anyone with him and establish the prayers and give the obligatory charity and keep the ties of kinship. طيب. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave him this answer. طيب. And he mentioned the example of Mu'ad ibn Jabal radiyallahu anhu, the famous hadith, the long hadith. طيب. So all of these hadith about the best deed to show you what was the way of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in answering several things to the same question. To the same question. The point is you should know the person who is asking you. This is important. This is important. يعني, as I said, this subhanAllah, يعني, the way of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is useful for you who are teaching Islam and also for any teacher. For any teacher. Okay? يعني, for example, if you are a doctor, you are طبيب أسنان, dentist, they tell you, yalla, tomorrow you are going to give a lecture. Okay? You'll find him, he will ask, I'm going to give a lecture for kids in the school, or for adults, or for what? Okay, so it is very important for him, because if he's going to speak to the kids, okay, maybe he will bring something with him, some fruits, okay, the brush teeth, he will bring some YouTube with him, and he will play some YouTube with him. Different than if it is for adults, 20 years and more. It is important for him. But imagine if he prepared slides. Okay? He wants to speak to adults or to doctors. He thinks that I'm going to give a lecture for doctors. Then no, you are giving to the kids in the school. Okay? Big problem يعني, for him. Unless he was prepared يعني, for that before. So you need the techniques for anyone. I mean for any field. طيب. Let's take this hadith. Anas radiyallahu ta'ala an reported, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and I were leaving the masjid, we met a man from the Bedouins near the door. He said, O Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when will the hour strike? This is page 592. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, woe to you, what have you prepared for it? Okay, so what do we learn from this hadith or until this part? Sometimes you don't need to answer the question. I should not answer every question. Should I answer all the questions? No, I should not answer the questions. This is because I don't know. No, it is not because I don't know. Yes, sometimes because I don't know. But sometimes the answer will not do anything for him. I mean for the questioner. So here the man asked about a sa'ah. The man asked about a sa'ah, the hereafter. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم doesn't know. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم doesn't know. But also, he wants to guide this person to something useful. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, what have you prepared for it? So what do we learn? We learn that guide the person, the one who asked you a nonsense question, useless question, difficult, okay? You guide him to a good question. Number one, the Prophet ﷺ doesn't know the answer. When the sa'a, when the hour will strike. It is only for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number two, if I tell you the hour will be after 10 years, what will you do? You'll be lazy for 9 years or for 9.5 years, and you'll think about the last few months to make tawbah. Everyone will think like that. Okay, and maybe we die after one day. So it will be useless for him, the answer. But the Prophet ﷺ wants to guide him and to prepare him. What did you prepare for that? Okay, so this is the important. Okay, oh teacher, when the exam? The exam tomorrow, after tomorrow. Are you ready for the exam? Don't ask the exam tomorrow, after tomorrow. You should be ready for the exam. Study for your exam. The exam tomorrow or after tomorrow? Okay, if I tell you after tomorrow, so tonight we'll not study. And if it is tomorrow, you will think to study. Or if I tell you the exam tomorrow, you'll tell me, oh teacher, what should I study? Can you give us something, a help, a hint, and something? Subhanallah. This is the human nature. Okay, so this is very important, brothers. We need to guide maybe our children, our friends, what to ask. This is very important. Don't feel that, wallah, I have to answer all the questions. No, you don't have to answer all the questions. And don't feel shame. Don't feel shame. If you don't know, I don't know. And if you have a way to guide the questioner, guide him to what is useful for him. Okay, of course, this is a very nice hadith. The man answered, oh Rasulullah, I didn't prepare much prayer, fasting or charity for it, but ولكن I love Allah and His Messenger. ولكن oh Rasulullah, wallah, I don't have a lot of qiyam al-layl or charity, but I have one thing, love of Allah and His Messenger. Alayhi salatu wasalam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam said, you are with those you love. You are with those you love. We asked, Anas said, we asked also. We asked, does this apply to us also? He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, yes. Yeah, also, this is only for this man or for us? Said, for you also. Tayyib, Anas said, radiallahu ta'ala, so we became very happy on that day. Subhanallah. Two brothers, they are happy because of what? Because of the akhirah. Not because of dunya. Now we'll be very happy. Ah, if I win a mobile, the latest iPhone or whatever, laptop, computer, a car, oh, khalas, I am the happiest person. What about the akhirah? We forget the akhirah. Not important. It is important, the most important. The akhirah. Anas radiallahu ta'ala said, I love Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Abu Bakr and Umar, and I hope that I will be with them by virtue of my love for them, even if I did not do the same deeds as them. Allahu Akbar. This is Anas, and what about us? He said, and also this is an important hadith. He said, I love Rasulullah, Abu Bakr and Umar. He did not say only I love Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He added Abu Bakr and Umar. Very high Abu Bakr and Umar. طيب. So he wished to be with them by his love, not by his deeds. Okay? So, we love them and our deeds, nothing. But we wish to be with them by our love to them. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to gather all of us in Firdaus. Jazakumullah khairan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.